us. He may be a mighty hunter, or man afraid of a bear, according as he is called by friend or enemy. And Scarface, to those who knew him by the eye's grasp only. No other fashion, I think, said so well with the various natures that inhabit in us. And if you agree with me, you will understand why so few names are written here as they appear in the geography. For if I love a lake known by the name of the man who discovered it, which endears itself by reason of the close locked pines it nourishes about its borders, you may look in my account to find it so described. Shall have their name, which is always beautifully fit and does not originate in the poor human desire for perpetuity. Nevertheless, there are certain peaks, canyons, and clear meadow spaces which are above all encompassing of words and have a certain fame, as of the nobly great to whom we give no familiar name. Guided by these, you may reach my country and find, or not find, according as it lies in you, much that is set down here and more. The earth is no wanton to give up all her best to every comer, but it keeps a sweet separate intimacy. Dependable, nor yourself less clever. There is a sort of pretense allowed in matters of the heart, as one would say by way of illustration, I know a man who, and so give up his dearest experience without betrayal. And I am in no mind to direct you to delectable places towards which you will hold yourself less tenderly than I. So, by this fashion of naming, I keep faith with the land, and annex to my own estate a very great territory to which none has a share.